Yossi and I spent 3 weeks in Oregon and Washington states. The main areas of our trip were Portland has several very beautiful gardens. We walked through the Japanese garden and the rose gardens and the Chinese garden. And here we are with Gary and Mala Siegel, our friends from Florida. Alex spent 11 weeks as an intern at Intel Corporation. When we met with him in Portland, he gave us a tour of the facility and his little cubicle. Every year, a bike or walk the bridges event takes place in Portland. This year, 19,000 people cycled or walked over Portland's bridges on this Sunday morning. And here we are at the finish line. This Saturday outdoor market attracts up to 200 vendors who sell produce, fish, meat, dairy products, baked goods, and other very good foodie items. Another fun thing to do on the weekend is the outdoor arts and crafts market. Very artsy and very funky.
She is braiding his beard.
Donut shop is one of Portland's major attractions. People stand online for up to half an hour to buy donuts that are known for their unusual flavors, shapes, and sizes. Bookstore claims to be the largest independent new and used bookstore in the world. More than 35,000 books under one roof, a block long and four stories high. The Columbia River Gorge is a canyon of the Columbia River and reaches up to 4,000 feet in depth. It stretches for over 80 miles as the river winds westward through the Cascade Range and forms part of the border between the states of Oregon and Washington. We spent 2 days in the Bonneville Hot Springs and Spa in Columbia Gorge. The pools are natural mineral water, and it was a great place to relax. The Cascades Loop passes through some of the most spectacular and diverse scenery in northwestern Washington, crossing the Northwest Mountain Range twice and continuing through Whidbey Island, beautiful Lake Chelan, and peaceful river valleys. This is the little town of Skykomish. We stopped here and had a picnic lunch. We stayed in Leavenworth for 2 nights. The town was transformed into a mock Bavarian village in the 1960s to revitalize its economy, and it's a popular tourist destination.
One day, I saw a man putting up an Israeli flag, and I asked him, how come?
He said,
God has said that you need to pray for Israel on a daily basis, and that's what we do. God bless.
That's an osprey nest, and there is the osprey nesting on top.
Lake Chelan is fed by streams from the Cascade Range and the Chelan Mountains. It has a maximum depth of almost 1,500 feet, and it is the third deepest lake in the country and the 26th deepest lake in the world.
Hello!
This is Deception Pass. George Vancouver gave it the name Deception because it had misled him into thinking Whidbey Island was a peninsula. Orcas Island is one of the larger islands in the San Juan Islands. Here we are waiting on the line to get to the ferry. The building on Main Street is where we had our studio apartment. And had a beautiful view of the water from our little balcony. That week, there happened to be a storytelling festival, and we just loved it. The participants were all professional storytellers, and it was a lot of fun.
He said, "Sire, it was a hard job you had me do, sir. Sir, she was wild, sir. Sir, she was rather unruly, sir. Sir, she kicked me."
His friends called him Sugar the Shop. When he came walking down the street, they say, "Here comes Sugar the Shark." He had candy wrappers sticking out of his shirt pockets. Chocolate smeared on his fingertips.
She couldn't get engaged in a real conversation with people. She didn't relate to people at all.
Now, there was a schneid. This does not look like a lot of landsmen in the house either. A schneider is what we call, you know from a schneider, a tailor.
I bet I could swim better than you could walk.
Oh yeah? I bet I could walk better than you could swim. Let's have a little contest.
If I can swim.
If I can walk better than you.
I get to eat.
I get to eat.
All the fish.
All the humans. I want splash!
This is the Rosario Hotel, where we spend the whole day in a spa, getting a massage, and having dinner. It was very, very pleasant.
Mount Constitution is the highest point on the San Juan Islands. Drive up to the top and get a great view all around. Thank you. Stowe Bay sits on the secluded southeastern shore, home to the Doe Bay Resort and Retreat, where clothing is optional. We stayed in the Crescent Lake Lodge for 3 days and loved it so much that we made a reservation for next year.
I enjoyed the swim in the lake, but it was very cold.
Near our lodge, there was a lovely trail in the rainforest called Moments in Time.
We are having a lovely
sardines with olives
in the rainforest. Beautiful.
In Hurricane Ridge, we drove up to an elevation of over 5,000 feet and saw some of the most spectacular views of the Olympic National Park. Rialto Beach is characteristic of the rocky beaches along the coast, with giant driftwood logs and pounding waves. This is Ruby Beach, where you can see these huge sea stacks. The rainforest is drenched in over 12 feet of rain a year. Olympic's west side valleys flourish with North America's best remaining examples of a temperate rainforest.
It clothed them. Most people think all tribes wore animal skins for clothing, but they did not. The Quinault tribe would use the cambium layer of the tree, which is the inner layer of bark that's very soft and absorbent. It's the layer that transmits water from the earth up into the